And so point D could be anywhere, and point C could be anywhere else. So there, connect D and C. Now, because AD is equal to AC, then triangle ADC will be isosceles. So angle ADC will be equal to angle ACD. And now, but angle ADC is greater than angle BDC. So, and again, because ADC is equal to ACD, so angle ACD will be greater than angle BDC. Much more is angle BCD will be greater than angle BDC. Now, if BD is equal to AC, BC, then triangle BDC will be isosceles. And then angle BDC should be equal to angle BCD. But we have proved that angle BCD is greater than angle BDC, which was absurd. So in this case, BD is unequal to BC. And now let's look at this case. That was point D was in this triangle ACB. So now connect D and C. Then produce AC. And at last produce line AD. And now, because AC is equal to AD, then again, triangle ACD is equilateral. So angle ACD will again equal to angle ADC. And we have proved that the angles under the base CD should be equal to each other. So it means angle ECD will be equal to angle FDC. Right. And now, because angle ECD was bigger than angle BCD, and again because ECD was equal to FDC, then angle FDC will also be greater than angle BCD. And much more is angle BDC will be greater than angle BCD. But we have a problem here, because if BD is equal to BC, then again triangle BDC will be isosceles. So angle BDC should be equal to angle BCD. But we have proof that angle BDC was greater than angle BCD, which was absurd. So in this case, again, BD is unequal to BC. And at last, if vertex D dropped on the line CB, it would be very, very evident to see that BD was unequal to BC.